What's up, everybody? Peacekeeper today for you guys. Welcome back to the Town Hall 13. We're going to be doing something really special today. You can see the new events. The Santa Surprise has just came back to the game. That is one of the newer spells. And then the brand new troop. Well, not really. I can't really say new troop, but the seasonal troop that comes around all the time, which is the Ice Wizard. The Ice Wizard is a really really good seasonal troop, and I like seeing it coming back into the game. So you can see the Ice Wizard is back for just a short time, only to put a freeze on your opponent's villages, also finish the task and get reward. So you finish the task and you will get 2 research potions. And then the epic winter challenge. So we'll be doing that a little later. Is this something really good? Get special rewards for earning 3 attacks of 1, 3 stars and earning 1 attack during this exclusive event. Can see the epic winter scenery as well and show off your skills with the temporary troop and spell. So you see the brand new scenery as well, so you guys will definitely get to see that. So in this video, we're actually using something brand new. Something I put off a lot of times, and I decided now I think it'd be the best time to use it. And that is the Super Witches. I have not used the Super Witches. I always put them off, and I decided, like, why not, let's use kind of Super Witches and some Super Wizards. A little bit of a ward and walk into Super Witches with the Super Wizards. And I just decided to boost the Super Archers because I haven't really used them much. I think they'd be good. Good little entry to the army. So, as you see, guys, I have max gold and a little bit of elixir, 13 minutes, and some decent dark as well. So first we will do, we have the Royal Champion that will be coming up again. So definitely will be saving that builder when the Royal Champion does come up, because I want to do a lot of wars in the future. I need to keep practicing as well. So I always try to practice in wars. So the first wall is going to be going on here to level 14 max. And we have finishing off, we ended up having 28 walls left. So I believe it's a good little process. So I probably will go with another Archer Tower, probably. Let's see how my time is working. Yeah, I was going to go with a bow, but I believe I'll go with an Archer Tower this time. So 16 million gold, 16 day upgrade in 3, 2, 1, bam. And the Archer Tower is going off the mat, so we'll slide it over to the mat side of the base. 2 Archer Towers left. That will be 2 upgrades for those as well. And then we have the cannons, which have 2 apiece. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. 14, so 14 upgrades left. 14 upgrades left for the Archer Towers, and 15 to finish those off. So what we're gonna do, let's hop into these attacks. So we're doing a couple with the Super Witches as well. So let's go. So okay, so this one is a pretty, I see this base a lot lately. Normally I hit it with Peckable Bat, and normally go over the top of the base. So let's see how the Super Witches can work on this one. So what I'm going to be doing here really quickly, I'm going to just decide where I want to ward a walk. And I'll probably ward a walk over here, where these couple storages are. Hopefully the warden can take out the, just take that out, take out that cannon, a storage or whatever he can get taken out. And that'll be a good thing for me. So I will drop the super railway drive super archer. The super archer has a lot of range, and that's what I like about them. I want to keep using the super archer. I think the super archer is a really good change to the game. Having that massive range and being able to shoot through walls, basically. You can see just that little bow go, the arrow goes directly through buildings. And it's a really good funneling troop, not gonna lie. And people use it a lot in farming. Okay, so the Super Archer is probably going to go down here. I probably should have realized that Tezza would have been there. It's fine. I'll drop the one of my witches, and then hopefully they can do a little funneling. I don't have much funneling. That's the only thing I would say bad about it. You can't use too many, because there's so much in housing space. They're 40, so not being able to use money it hurts a bit. But the Super Witches are going to start off. I probably took a lot of time using them, especially with the Warden Walk, because this just takes so long. The Warden just takes so long to funnel, and the Super Witches are really, really slow. So it seems like everything is going on the outside. All of the Super Witches are going on the outside. This is sad. So not being able to funnel on the top was really, really bad. So I will freeze that single turret in front of the tower, and everything is gonna walk. This one is sad. So I need to heal in the middle. I will pop the queen's ability, and then it will freeze the scatter. But everything just walked. Not having much cleanup or having stuff to funnel hurts, because super witches are just so. They cost a lot of holding space, 40 holding space a witch. So I really tried to put in as much funneling stuff as possible, but it couldn't work. I probably could drop a couple of the. I could probably drop the super archer and probably use that to funnel, but nah, I think I can work with it. I probably may not worry about using the king in the middle of the base. I probably use him for funneling. I think I could do that instead. But we'll keep working on this one. If I decide to change it, I will. So we will let super just work here. They have a lot of hit points as well, which is a good thing, but it just really, really slow. So I probably need to speed up the one of what. Probably should have one of what over here. Drop a super witch and probably a couple wizards, because the super wizards do not, the ice wizards, sorry, they do not target buildings like the normal wizards do. They actually target defenses. So 20 trophies there to end off that one. I will request again, and then we will hop into the next attack here in a bit when everything is cooked up. But we will actually go over to the new one of the new stuff over here, the Epic Winter Challenge. Hopefully we can do good on this Epic Winter Challenge, and then I will cut the video as well to get the troops training, and then we'll do the last attack. So let's hop into this Epic Winter Challenge. Oh wow, I love, wow, this looks super cool. So look at this. You can see the king, the two kings here, basically a hallway to, wow, this looks really cool. I love what they did here. You can see there's basically the town hall type stuff here, and it's all winter. Wow, this just looks really cool. I love the sceneries in the game, and there's a little village right here, which looks really, really cool. So if you guys do buy it, there's a creator code, so you guys can use the creator codes that are in the game and use your favorite one as well. I don't have one. I need probably 1,000, 2,000 subscribers to decide to get it. So if you guys do know people that do have the Supercell code, you can use theirs as well to support them as well. So we have the sand surprises, which the sand surprise don't really do much. They're basically like I would say, I want to call them a troll item in a way. I really do. So let's see. We're just gonna look around the base here. Where do I want to enter? We don't have any siege machines. We have the ice hounds as well. So no balloons. That's gonna hurt. But I will draw a couple ice wizards with the ice golem. I will drop the king, the queen, and the warden with the royal champion here, and I'm basically gonna do fun spam. Why not spam? Spam is the name of the game. I have ice hounds, and the ice hounds probably won't be able to do nothing much. I'm just basically gonna spam in the Santa surprises. Why not? I will freeze that. I probably should drop some of the heroes over to the Santa with the Santa surprises. Or if the ice gun, I probably should drop them up here at the top, because the warden, war champion, don't go down, please. I will freeze it again because I want to save. Nope, royal champion dies. So everything is basically being targeted. We'll probably have to do this off camera to get it, like another shot at it. I will pop the warden's ability to help save some of the barbarians because the king is dead. The king actually fought the enemy king and died. I will freeze again. Yep, I finally got both of the single and the two grumbles. So it's weird not having balloons or anything. I'm gonna freeze that again. Only thing I have is the queen's ability, and I probably won't get it just because of the two grumbles. So I need to find a good way where to come in, and if I do, I probably build triple. We'll triple this. I'll probably do it off camera. But this one looks really cool and will part the queen's ability. The ward is going to die off, so we definitely won't be getting the triple on this one. Just basically spam it. Why not? Have a little fun with this stuff. So we will end it off here because the queen will die off to the buzz. And that is the end of that. So we'll definitely do that one off camera for sure to get that triple. And then we'll definitely be getting those stuff, the gems and the shovel of obstacles. But I'll be back with you guys really quickly when the army is cut up so we can do the last one for the video. Okay everyone, so everything is cut up. We didn't get any CC troops, but that's totally fine. I'm not really going the hardcore push on this league day as well. So we have the army cut up, so let's hop into the last attack for the video. So one thing I decided, okay, this one doesn't look too bad either. So I decided to actually use the king 2 funnel. So I believe that would be the better thing for me to do. I'm going to go away here, make it more of a YOLO type thing around the base. So the king will basically come down here with a couple ice wizards when he gets aggroed by some defenses. And then that's basically going to hopefully slow down some defenses so the king doesn't die too quickly. Hopefully take out some, send the wrecker into that compartment with the super witches. The wrecker doesn't have any CC troops, so hopefully something can basically follow the wrecker into the town hall. So that's what I'm banking on. Hopefully it works out. It probably won't, but we'll see how that goes. So I'll probably drop a king with a super witch. I believe that'd be best thing to help out funneling there. I have the support archers as well, so the support archers are probably going with the main bulk of the army. I'll pull the warden here in a bit. I'll drop the super archer there to help snipe off that defense and the storage. I'll drop the queen in here, drop the wrecker. So the super witch is going to die here now. Yeah, so she's going to die here. I'll drop the other super witches with the super wizards. I basically just spammed them all in. It is fine, totally fine, why not? And the warden's gonna die now. So yeah, the pop his ability. I'm gonna freeze the multi. The wrecker is going in, but nothing is basically following behind. So this one definitely is gonna be another one star. Well, gonna be a one star. So this one went pretty bad. I'm not worrying anyway, not worrying anymore, honestly. The queen is gonna go over here, and then this one is gonna definitely be one. So I draw the poison on the witches, but they actually jump back out. Ooh, I dropped the freeze for no reason. I'm not worrying about this one, basically just trying to have a little bit of fun with these super witches. I'm not good with them anyways, but it's my first time using them. I always held off not to use them, honestly, just because they were so much housing space. So I'm not worrying about if I do triple or fail with them. I will use that last freeze though, and I won't use the rage I have. I'll let the queen pop ability. Normally I would end the raid, but we'll hopefully get some more of this loot and percentage points to end off this one. It's totally fine with me. I'm not worrying about any trophies, honestly. You get this one star and be totally fine with it. The minion is working on the gold collector, and this one will probably be the last building it does get before time runs out. So yep, it gets the mine. Oh, it actually got the dark drill. But 13 trophies, one star, totally fine with me. I'm not worrying much about it. But that is the end of that attack. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, hit the like button, don't forget to subscribe. Hit the notification bell as well to not miss any Clash of Clans content. I hope you guys did enjoy looking at the new scenery. But I hope you guys have an awesome day. I'm Peacekeeper, and I'm out.